Hello. So we are today talking about online examination again. Last week also we talked about online examination and the pros and cons attached to it. So online examination on the whole, when we discussed during the COVID-19 situation, is a very thoughtful and a very important decision that has been taken. But also there are many pros and cons to online examination. Let's not just, you know, categorize online examination on the basis of the benefits or the basis of the losses, but also how accessible it is right now during the time of crisis. Firstly, we have to remember that online examination is very environment friendly because it saves a lot of energy. Energy in the sense that, you know, traveling cost, the money associated with it, maybe the cost of the examination hall, that is the use of electricity that is being saved, that is the use of fuels that's being saved. So it's very environment friendly, firstly. Secondly, it's a very technologically, you know, backed up source of examination. It's a very technologically forward source of way of doing examination, because we are doing examination online. We're using the help of internet and accessing examination and trying to benefit from it. Then it is also, it reduces a lot of labor cost. Okay, so during this time, a lot of labor is also invested. That is getting cut. Also, we have to remember that, you know, we're acquiring a lot of information when we're doing online examination. In terms of that, how to access things, how to operate things, how to operate internet and computer, we are trying to know that, we are trying to understand that. Okay, now when it comes to disadvantage, we have to understand the fraudulence that is being committed because of online examination. And also we have to remember, if individuals are from a village, or if the individual is from a place where internet is not available, it's a very difficult thing for them to continue with the examination. So we have to keep in mind the pros and cons of the whole process. See, in India, basically the student-teacher interaction is being reduced and being compromised because of online examination. But I think more or less when things become better and accessible, online examination will be soon made offline. But for the time being, let's focus on the pros of the thing which is there and manage with the cons, right? And also we have to remember one thing, that whatever is the situation, we have to make the best and the good, you know.
Hello friends, so I'm Shaptarshi and I'm studying chemistry at IIT Kanpur. And so I'll just give my review on online examinations. And so first of all, before getting into the topic, I like to divide online examinations in two formats, which is normally seen. One is your Viva and one is your the normal written exams that we have. Coming to the first part of Viva, I have no problem. I think having online Viva like has been going on even before the pandemic. So for the ones who don't know, I'll just say, like, people who actually go abroad to do their master's or PhD, and when they come back, like for a teaching position in some college, they actually have an online Viva with the Indian professors at that time. So this has been going on for a long time, even before lockdown or pandemic. So there is no problem with having online Vivas. Coming to the second part and the interesting part that which we faced in 2020 is our online written exams. And I'll just say it's absolutely bogus. There is no meaning of online written exams. First of all, I'll give the reason, the power of the internet. Okay, now it depends, right? Whether you're a bachelor's student or a master's student or a PhD student, don't really have that many examinations, only in their course will they have. So for a, say, school student, bachelor's student, it absolutely gets bogus because you get almost every basic thing in the internet, right? Even for a master's student, right? Even if you don't get the basic things, you will obviously get hints from here and there and over here. Now, some people enjoy this fact that you know, you can get easy marks and all these things. But I'd like to just ask all of you, like, whom are we trying to fool? Like, there's no point, that we cannot get away in life, right? It reminds me of a Bible verse which says, like, you will sow what you reap. You will sow what you reap, right? So there's no two ways of getting at it. Because if you study less, there will be consequences in the future. If you study more and prepare yourself, equip yourself, there will be positive consequences to that. Right, I'll just give an example of that. Right, suppose a guy who's qualifying examination, just as we saw, like in Calcutta University and other university exams also in India, there were online examinations, people qualified, like it was almost like 99% plus qualifications of everyone, right? And they went to their masters, right? So the problem is that when these people go to their masters and when actually the offline thing resumes or whatever resumes, right, they will be having very much problems because their basics are not clear because they have not studied, right? Consider the part when a master's student goes to your go for a teaching position in some school or whatever, right? So what will the like students think when they see their teacher like always consulting notes, always consulting Google and not being able to answer their questions? So you cannot fool anyone, right? And this is even for me, it gets very easy because you can have open book, write things easily. But in the long run, we are the ones who are going to suffer for this. And I'll say, I'm not blaming some students or something like that. Don't take it like that. I'm blaming the whole system. Okay. And it's not that I'm blaming them. It's just like the thing has been like this. So I don't know what is the better alternative in this pandemic situation. But this whole system, there's no motivation factor to study. We are not meeting our friends who get more marks. See, all these things which were like all this pressure that you used to have in our school days, high school days, bachelor days, or masters, whoever studies masters, right? These are positive things that actually builds up a person. And if we are just going to escape things like have like things easily in our life, I think we are the ones who are going to suffer. And it reminds me of a saying in Proverbs, which says, an iron sharpens iron. And as we are studying alone, we have no one beside us who's studying with us, we are not having a healthy competition, and we are not getting sharpened, and we are just getting blunt and blunt and blunt. So I really hope that this pandemic ends soon and that we can have offline examinations and offline study also with our friends, with everyone else, right? So have a good day and God bless all.
Hello, I am Shreyan Roy and I am from Calcutta. So, in this video, I will tell you about the advantages and disadvantages of online exams. So, in this corona situation, online exams are not available when college, university and schools conduct the exams. So, online exams are advantages and disadvantages. Disadvantage, exam friendly department. মানে তুমি ঘরে বসে পরীক্ষা দিচ্ছ, এবার পুরো লয়ালিতে তুমি পরীক্ষাটা দেবে না, মানে মোস্ট অফ দ্য স্টুডেন্টই দেবে না, এটা অবভিয়াস। সো এক্সাম ফ্রেন্ডলি ব্যাপারটা থাকে না, চিটিং, পিডিএফস এক্সেট্রা এক্সেট্রা। এবার আরেকটা ডিসঅ্যাডভান্টেজ হলো মানে বাচ্চাদের মেরিট, ওটা তো জাজ করা যায় না, কারণ কি অল অফ দেম আর গেটিং দ্য সেম গ্রেডস, মানে ইকুয়াল গ্রেডস আর, তাই জন্য মেরিট কার কতটা ওটা তো বোঝা যায় না। না আর থার্ডলি হলো মানে you scan the papers and you submit it PDF mele dao, so it is very time complexity bere jay, mane jeta offline hoto mane you submit directly to the teachers hand, kintu ekhane mane network issue hote pare, tar pore if the time is crossed then college ke chithi lekho mail koro je amar ei jonno, mane network issue ta ekta fact hoye geche. So disadvantage o ache, mane disadvantage chilo ei gulo. So our advantage bolte ami bolte chai je you are getting good grades, eta the advantage, mane bhalo cgpa hold korbe, bhalo marks hold korbe. Next advantage holo kom pore beshi marks.
Hello everyone, this is Abhilasha and today we are going to talk about the pandemic lifestyle. So it has almost been a year that the pandemic has hit us and we all are aware of the associated claustrophobia that is pertaining with it, and most importantly speaking, the two most things that has hit the lowest mark is personally our societal skills, that is social mixing, and professionally our academic and work skills. Needless to say that the best way to curb infection is to hold online examinations, and everyone is doing that with their best possible intentions, but in the long run it is not the best way to judge a student's individual intellectual capacities, because not every place in India is equipped with the best technological infrastructure even as of 2021, and even as we speak, some village or some suburb in say outside Calcutta or India is still having the ill effects of power flaws. But then again, online examinations is extremely economical, power saving, so as to say that they require less amount of paper, less to zero amount of paper. And we all know that each student needs a certain amount of creative freedom that they do not get in the examination halls, because all they focus is how to top their exam, but not understanding that ultimate goal of every academical intention is to achieve the best of education that is possible. So if done properly, I personally think that this online examination system will work wonders to improve the current educational system in India, as well as the student and educational relationship graph that has unfortunately been falling. So if done in the best of intentions, then I think it will suffice. Thank you.
2020 brought too many extraordinary things for us to witness, and one of the change it brought in our daily life was the conduct of online examinations. So online exams are good or bad, it's quite controversial, but in my opinion, it's a boon for our education system. Earlier we used to be dependent on the Rutta technique, like where students used to learn quite things by just memorizing them. It was a game of memorization. Right now, the things are quite messed up and the conduct of the examination is poor. But if it could have been conducted with proper coordination and proper technical support, it could have been a beginning of a new era. The era of new education system, where all the things could have been online. I think this unconventional way of examination and extraordinary situation provided a gate for the new education system. In this new normal, the education system could be a boon where it needs certain improvements in certain sections, and we need to be technically advanced, and only then the future of the education system is too bright with online mode of education.